such a time as this.
Captivated. No, I'll never be the same.
with just one look. Yes, everything changes. Oh, I'm captivated. Oh, I'll never be the same with just one look. God, everything changes, and I'm captivated. Oh, I'll never be the same with just one look. Everything changes, yes, I'm captivated. I'll never be the same. Yes, I'm so in love with you. You're beautiful, so beautiful. Yeah, I'll fix my eyes on you.
Tenderness in his eyes. You can feel it, the love. He's not looking at you with judgment and hatred. Come on, the love of a father. I don't know about you, but when my dad looks at me, there's something about it. You can see all the love that he has, that he cares so much, that he would do anything for you. But just his look. I know for me, when my dad walks into a room, I immediately feel peace. I immediately feel safe. Come on, that's what the Father in heaven, that's what his look can do for you. Come on, it can bring such peace and such purpose and such life. Come on, he has you in his hand. With just one look from God, what can happen? What can happen? Come on, this morning, can we ask God, would you just look my way? Would you glance my way? Come on, I want to be captivated. Come on, there's something about a look from a father. Come on, everything changes. Jesus. I'm so in love. I'm so in love with you. You're beautiful, so beautiful. I'll fix my eyes on you. You're beautiful, so beautiful. 'Cause with just one look, everything changes. I'm captivated. I'll never be the same. 'Cause of just one look, everything changes. My heart's captivated. I'll never be the same. What is up, G5?
Woo, woo!
Come on, happy Sunday. Guess what today is?
It's Mother's Day.
Mom's Day. We are so excited that we got the opportunity to spend Mother's Day with you. What an honor.
It's amazing. We love Mother's Day.
Yes.
Because, to be honest, we all wouldn't be here without mothers.
Yeah.
It's the truth, if you think about it. But we love it because, obviously, we have an amazing mother.
We have an incredible mom.
We have an incredible mom, and we have so many amazing moms that come to church and like tune into all our weekly services we've been doing online, and it's amazing because
we get to celebrate them today.
We get to celebrate it. It's like
cool.
A celebration, like
we're
the Cooligan song.
We're here to celebrate you today. Moms are absolutely incredible. The gift that God has given, just the power of a mom. And so we're so excited today to celebrate you. Kids, we know that you are so grateful for your mom. But we're excited. Today we're going to have some fun.
It's going to be a blast.
Our two favorite people are going to come and spend some incredible moments with you, and we're so excited about it. But our incredible mom.
Our incredible mom.
And our incredible,
dad.
Yeah, they're going to spend some moments with you. So stay tuned.
It's going to be
Get
awesome.
Get ready. God's going to work.
Buck your seatbelt. It's going to be awesome.
We love you. Happy Mother's Day.
It's on.
It's on.
G5 family. It's Mother's Day.
It is Mother's Day.
Happy
it's
Mother's
Sunday
Day.
Sunday Mother's Day.
Happy
Thank
Mother's
you.
Day. Woo! Our first favorite day of the week.
That's it.
I hope
That's
you
it.
Were with us Tuesday night, man. Did we have some fun talking about tone
we did.
And the home?
We had so
What
much
a privilege.
Fun.
Yes. But today, man, we're going to celebrate moms. Moms, you're so amazing. We just wanted to remind you of how powerful you are. The difference that you make in this world. I know sometimes that you get caught in the mundane of every day.
Every day.
Just doing what you do. You got your schedules way too full. You got questions you don't have answers to. You're dealing with things that people don't even know about. You're concerned, and some of you are even worried. Man, you're worried. I'm worried about my children. I'm worried about my family. I'm worried about my parents. Our parents. And Gay and I just want to come by today and just speak some hope, speak some peace, and speak some vision into your life, because you really do matter. How powerful are moms, huh?
They really are. They're so incredible. I love what my son said. I was thinking about it today. Like, truthfully, we all wouldn't be here if it weren't for a mom and really a dad. And it's such a powerful, powerful thing that we get to be a mom. And before we really talk much more, we want to talk just a few minutes like about our moms. I know that a lot of you right now may be like me, which is a situation where you have your mom who is actually in a nursing home right now so that you can't even see her. You can't even go. All you can do is stand outside in front of the glass and hold up the sign and just say, I love you. And it's just so incredibly hard. Mine actually lives in North Carolina. I haven't even been able to see her. But, you know, I remember so many amazing memories and the selflessness of a mom. And I want to talk a little bit more about that. But, you know, one thing I remember, and this is probably going to sound kind of crazy, but I remember this so distinctly because I remember my mom getting up early every single morning, Monday through Friday, and her big thing was she wanted to make sure that we had this amazing lunch to take to school. We went to a small Christian school. We didn't have a cafeteria.
Yeah.
And when she found out that we were going to be eating out of what I called a construction site truck that would pull up, she's like, no, 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 not our kids. And I remember every morning her getting up. I'm seriously, moms, I remember her making hamburgers at 6 a.m.
What?
And then putting them in foil and putting all the ingredients. People, when I would get to school, people would say, let's find out what Gaye has for lunch, because it was always amazing. But it was a selfless act that my mom did. And what's crazy, she probably wouldn't even know that I'm remembering that. That I am remembering those moments when she got up so selfless to take care of me and my brothers.
That's so wild you talk about that, because I remember having the packed lunch and all my rich friends, they got to eat in the cafeteria. But my friends would come to me every day and say, I'll trade you my meal for your packed lunch.
That's right.
Because my mom would throw down. See, some of y'all don't know anything about bologna, but man, I knew about bologna and I loved it. And my mom, man, what an incredible, incredible leader. I want to tell you, I'm also grateful for your mom, Sylvia, because without your mom, guess what? I wouldn't have this beautiful moment and us have two amazing children and being able to sit here on the couch. Sorry, I messed you up.
That's okay.
But, you know, moms are amazing. I know now, today, some of you, when you think about moms, Gaye, they're smiling, you're happy. But I know some of you, your heart is so sad because your memories and your moments maybe weren't that great. Maybe there was brokenness. Maybe there are only memories of pain. And I just want to say to you today that God's given you and I a moment, Mom,
amen,
to break the curses of yesterday. And I want to encourage you, if your memories are bad with your mom, will you just maybe do yourself a favor today, and that is get a piece of paper and find a quiet place and write a letter to your mom and just say, Dear Mom, I want you to know I'm grateful. We had some pains, we had some moments, we had some turbulence, we had some rocky moments, but Mom, I'm just so grateful that you gave me life.
Amen.
I would encourage you to do that today. Some of you are dealing with moms like she is, that she's in a home and you can only wave through a window, and some of you have recently lost your moms and that hole is so massive. I will tell you, I lost my mom in 1975. Still, the moments, the memories, the moments that I could just talk to her and sit with her, the wisdom, the kindness, the gentleness, the fighter. My mom loved to laugh. I just want to challenge you, moms, and inspire you today that in the mundaneness of being a mom, in the times of just being exhausted and worn out, don't forget who you're raising. Don't forget that you could be raising the next leader in the world, and I believe you are, that it's going to change the world. They're going to change the circumstances in people's lives. Moms, don't get worried in well-doing. I know right now they act like they're not listening. I know right now they act like they don't hear you, but I just want to encourage you. Be strong. There's a powerful scripture in the Bible that says, though they be dead, yet he still speaks. Even though in 1975, my mother was killed tragically in an automobile accident, I still hear her voice. You got this. Son, I'm proud of you. Moms, today you're creating miracles with your words and your life. We're not trying to stress you out. We want to pour into you and let you know how valuable you are and the difference that you can make. I want you to be encouraged today. I want you to be strong because God's word in you can be so strong. I don't know about you, and you're going to talk about it a little bit. I can't wait for her to just pour in you, but boy, I'm so grateful for my mom's faith. She taught us how to pray. She taught us to believe God. She would over and over again, when we were in need, we didn't have a lot, we couldn't run places and get things, she would just believe God. And she taught us to trust Him and believe Him. And truthfully, so much what you see pouring out of our lives today was deposited because of the faith that God had given a beautiful woman. Martha Goad, I love you.
Moms, you matter. You say, Tim, are you emotional because you're weak? No. No, I'm emotional because I have a sense that there's a mother listening to me right now that you don't know today and the last few years of your life, the impact that you're having. Mom, your example is so incredible. Your love for God, your love for your family, your love for your friends, your love for life, your love for the future, your love even for the struggles, those days when we're kind of tired. Be strong.
Amen.
Be of good courage. God is with you. Will you just talk to the mom to mom now?
I will.
And hey, watch this. I even put a little Kleenex in my pocket because I was thinking I may need it, you know. Look at there. So go for it, baby cakes.
Okay.
Happy Mother's Day.
Thank you. Right. I love
All
you.
Right. Love you.
Love you. You know, I'm so excited about this opportunity, and I will tell you, it takes a lot of weight, because I so want to encourage moms, but I want to equip us at the same time, and understand that I'm coming from a place of realness because I am one, and I've been there, done that, failed that, felt discouraged, felt all of it. But one of the things I know about the mom is that there's a power and a privilege and a responsibility wrapped up in a lot of opportunities. There's a privilege and a responsibility wrapped up in a lot of opportunities. You and I, mom, get to be selfless. I could just stop right there. And we could sit and talk about how selfless you and I get to be a mom. Because truthfully, the only way that we can be a mom is to set ourselves aside. And it's not always easy. When you're single, it's like, woohoo, we got life, we can go here, we can go there. When we get married, we grab our husband, we run here, we run there. And then all of a sudden we're a mom and we go, I can't run there. Oh, wait, I can't do that. I've got these amazing children. And so we get to be selfless. We get to stretch. We get to believe. We get to love. We get to hold. We get to correct. We get to guide. And then we get to release. The power of a mom. I want to tell you this. There's never been a perfect mom, and there never will be. So quit trying to be the perfect mom. Quit trying to get it all together. Quit trying to make it all make sense, because it probably isn't going to. So I want to chat with you. I don't want to talk at you. I don't want to talk to you. I want to chat with you. I want this to be real today. The first thing that I want to talk about, and you're going to love me. If you know me, I got some titles.
Come on.
Because I want something to stick in your head. First thing I want to talk to you about is the Spanx of motherhood.
Woo!
The Spanx of, if you're a man watching, you're going, what is she talking about? Is she talking in a foreign language? No, if you're a woman over the age of 16, you know what I'm talking about.
I've seen them.
Hey, he's seen them. They're in my closet. There is a woman that invented this little product called a Spanx. It tucks it in. It keeps it in. It stretches things that shouldn't be stretched. And it hides things that, praise God, need to be hidden.
I need some of those.
Woo! You know what? They may have them.
No, really?
Okay. I don't know. We're not going to go there. But anyway, but what I want to talk to you about is that every day you and I get up and we put on our spandex Spanx superhero outfit. Every day we get up and we put it on. I know you know what I'm talking about. Yours is hanging in the closet right now. Or you may have it on while you're watching this. But I want to talk to you about something powerful before that. Before we can even begin to conquer, because you and I, when we get up, we're the superhero and we're going to conquer. And before we can even begin to conquer what's ahead of us that day, you and I get to conquer what's in us for that day.
Yeah.
I'm going to say it one more time. Before we can even begin to conquer what's ahead of us that day, you and I get to conquer what's in us that day. And you and I know, as ladies, as women, as young girls, there's a lot in us. The first thing that you and I get to do when we get up in the morning, ladies, is we get to take the mirror test. The mirror test, what is that? We get greeted by a mirror every single morning. A man-made invention. Some person invented that mirror, and you and I choose to believe the mirror over a God that created us. You and I know, I'm not just preaching, I'm talking to moi. I get up every morning and I believe what that mirror says. Well, you know what's crazy? And I wrote this. I wrote a book called More. You are more than your reflection in the mirror. Why did I do that? Because I believe we get up as ladies every morning and we don't even understand that that mirror doesn't show our gifts. It doesn't show our passion. It doesn't show our pain. It doesn't show our hurt. It shows an image that the world thinks we should look like. And you and I believe it. You and I start believing this mirror. The second thing when we get up in the morning, guess what? We join in the comparing game immediately. We join in the comparing game. We compare our superhero outfit to everybody else. You know what's crazy? I've already talked about one thing. I'm on two things now, and I haven't even talked about comparing ourselves as a mom. I'm just talking about comparing ourselves as a woman. You and I get up in the morning and we are constantly comparing our looks. We look at other women, we compare our inadequacies to them. Oh, look at them, look how great they look. We are constantly comparing. And oh yeah, then we start to compare as a mom. Then we get to the mom thing. And see, I can talk with you with integrity because I've been there and I've done this. I've compared. See, I couldn't even perform my hero feats for the day because all I could do was criticize what I saw. And there was so much that I needed to do. Ladies, if I could, I would stop by your house right now, wherever you are. I literally would get in my car, no matter what they say, and I would walk into your house and I would beg you to start living the life that God fully called you to live in the body He called you to live it in. Am I saying we don't take care of ourselves? No. God gave us a temple to make sure we take care of it. God gave us a temple to make sure that we steward it. But I am saying that if you cannot accept the fact that you are wonderfully and fearfully made, you and I don't stand a chance, because you and I can't start our mom day wrapped up in the wrong mom image. We can't start our mom day wrapped up in the wrong mom image. What is that? Our image is that God knew that we could be a mom. Whoever God calls, He also prepares. He also equips. And you and I are equipped. I'm telling you, moms, you and I can do this. One of the biggest things that you and I do, because I've talked about our superhero outfits, is we get them on and we're ready to start the day, and we go out and we see other moms, and the first thing we do is compare that suit. We look over and go, well, she doesn't even have any stains on her suit. She doesn't even have any rips. This is what we do. Her suit fits her like a glove. She looks incredible in that suit. I remember the day that I was at Breanne's, I go back because she was three. She was Breanne at the time. And I was at her class for dance. And we homeschooled our children. And I remember sitting there and the kids were dancing and the moms were talking, and this mom goes, "Oh yeah, I took Julia to the arts studio the other day, and the lady was just blown away at the way she could draw, and she just couldn't believe it." And the lady goes, "Oh, I know. I took our kids the other day to this, I can't even name the school, some fancy school. And they were blown away at the way she could put full sentences together and they would spell a word and she could just spell it right away. And they all started talking and I just started getting this feeling and I started looking at my superhero outfit and I'm like, I can't be like them. I don't understand. I don't know how to do that because that doesn't sound like our kids. Our kids are different than that. And I can't say that they did that. And I can't say that maybe they put a full sentence together. And I can't say, and I can't. And I walked out and I heard God's voice so strong. And God's voice said to me, "Get in your car. Go to the first local store you can find. Buy the best pair of earplugs they sell and buy some blinders like they put on the horse for the race. You run the race I called you as a mom to race, not as the other mom in her superhero outfit. Yeah, he can speak like this. Yeah, he can do this. She can do this. What about what I've called you to your children and the mom that I've called you to be?" And I realized that I had to stop comparing my super outfit. I had to stop it. The second thing I want to talk to you about is your view of God, ladies, will determine how you mother. Wow. Your view of God will determine how you mother. Are you convinced that he made a mistake by calling you to be a mom? Or are you convinced that he said, "Tag, you're it. You got this. You can do this. I know. You got a kid on one hip. You got another one grabbing your leg. You can't, I'm going to get real, you can't even pee in peace." Guess what? God equipped you to be a mom. But your view of him and your view of what he has for you is only everything. Guess what I call this? I call this the gospel according to mom. What do I mean by that? You and I get to show Jesus. How? Oh my word. The days, the minutes, the millions of times that I had to ask forgiveness. Did I? Oh, because day after day, I made mistakes. Day after day, I didn't do it right. And I had to look in my children's eyes and say, "Please forgive me." You know what else, Mom? You and I get to let our kids hear us call their names out in prayer. "Father, I just thank you for our daughter. Father, I just thank you for our son. I thank you for what you're doing in their lives." You get to show them Jesus every day. Let me tell you this. The gospel they see you live will be bigger and better than any scripture you could ever read. The gospel they see you and I live. They need to, you know what I said? The other day I was talking to a lady and she said this to me. "You don't understand. I've got 4 children. I don't have time to go set up a prayer closet." She'd watch The War Room and it'd get you motivated. "I'm gonna make me a prayer closet." I got motivated. I cleared all my shoes out. I cleared everything out. I put all my little stickers on the wall. They're still there, but you can't see them now because the shoes got put back in there. And I got on my knees for a week. Oh, and I'm not, please hear me. If that's what God's called you to do, keep it up. But I realized right away, I did not have time for the prayer closet, but by God, I could pray while I was folding some laundry. And I could pray while I was washing the dishes. And I could pray in the car while my children are there and we have worship music going. And I can call out and thank Jesus. I can pray for the man that's on the side of the road whose car broke down. I can pray for the ambulance that I hear go by. "Father, be with that person. I thank you for touching their body." That's how you can pray. Take prayer with you. Take God with you.
Yeah.
The gospel according to mom is huge. I remember my mom, she did teach us faith. I remember her screaming out and calling out for God. I can remember the oil coming out, and I used to think she was crazy. Oh God, I'd say, here comes the oil. But she knew that when something was wrong, we brought out the oil and we prayed. You and I get to call out our kids and get to ask them to forgive us and get to show Jesus. Remember, it's not about being perfect. It's about being present. It's about being present. Number three. Oh, I think I just need to park here. Don't play the wish game. Moms, I'm begging you. I know you're tired. I know you need a break. I get it. But don't start the wish game where you wish your mom moments away. What do I mean? We've all said it. Oh, I just wish they would be quiet. Have you ever done that? Okay, we're gonna play the quiet game. Everybody be quiet. In the car, everybody be quiet. Let's just play the mommy game, which is everybody be quiet. Or have you ever said, I just wish they would go away for a while. Ooh. Understand the weight that that carries right there. Oh, I just wish you could have been different. Oh, I just wish God would have given me one that wasn't such a pain. Oh, I just wish. Am I making you feel guilty? No, I'm making you become aware because I've been there, done that. Don't wish it. Do you know there's a mom right now at the sound of my voice who has lost a child, who would give anything to have those moments back? Don't wish them away. Embrace them. I know it's tough. I know it's hard. And we do need time to regroup. And Dad, this is where you get to come in. This is where Tim was so amazing. He jumped in and he said, let me take the kids. And he would take the kids and go do something. You know what's crazy? 30 minutes would go and I'd call him and go, hey, where are you? I didn't need much. I wanted to be with our family. But I just needed that little bit of time. You need to be renewed. I'm not saying you don't, but don't wish it away. Because what happens is you're going to wake up one day and what you wished is going to be gone. I remember the day I was at Cracker Barrel. And we had been there at the restaurant. I've got a bag I want to pull out. And we had been at the table. And one of the things we did with our kids is we love to play games. Don't get mad at me. Maybe this is what you do, but we don't like electronics at the table. We want to have conversation. We want to have fun. We want to make memories. And so I would carry Hot Wheels and I would carry Army Men in my purse. My bag weighed a ton. Can I get a witness? Have you ever left a restaurant and took 20 minutes to make sure you got everything that you brought because it's been scattered at the table? So I'm in line paying and I'm digging through my purse and the Hot Wheels and the Army Men are falling out and the lady cashing me out said, oh my gosh, don't you hate that? She said, I cannot wait for the day when I don't have to carry that. I wish my son and my daughter didn't ask me to carry all their stuff all the time. And I said to her, oh my word, ma'am, no. Because I know that one day they won't ask me to carry those things. And I won't have that moment anymore. I don't want to wish away the moment. I remember my daughter, we would travel. We were always on the road. We were always in hotels. One of my favorite pictures is Bree sitting in my lap. I'm in the long mirror that you have at the hotels. I'm sitting on the floor. I can guarantee you we only had a few minutes to get ready to hit the stage. And she's in my lap and she's like, Mom, makeup. She's in my makeup. And I'm like this trying to put it on. And then she would always go, whips, Mommy, whips. And she would stick her lips up and she would want me to put lipstick. See, I don't want to miss the mommy moments. I don't know about you. So what do? This is my lipstick bag. I don't go anywhere without it. Because this little girl without lipstick somehow goes away. Anybody know what I'm talking about? If you don't, I love you. You're wonderful. But in my bag, wherever I go, I have an Army Man. And I have her favorite, cookie dough. Whips and Army Men. So that when I go in and I'm tired, but I'm getting all my lipstick to cover up all the stuff and how I feel. I look in and I see my mommy moment that I don't want to miss. We don't want to miss them. We don't want to wish them away. We want to keep them. I want you to remember something. This is so powerful. Please remember this right here. I just saw this the other day and it hit me like a 2x4. And I know what a 2x4 is now because we got them all over the ranch. Thanks to Josh and Joe and everybody, I'm learning what a 2x4 is. I got hit by a 2x4 and this is what it said. It's not what you gather, it's what you scatter. And I had to stop and think for a second. I got my phone out, I typed it in. It's not what you gather, it's what you scatter. You and I get the privilege to scatter. We get to scatter Jesus. We get to scatter love. We get to scatter peace. We get to scatter understanding. We get to scatter assurance. We get to scatter boundaries. We get to scatter hope. And we get to scatter forgiveness. You and I get to scatter. I'm gonna be closing in just a minute. And I just wanna let you know, moms, that I love you. I hope in any way you don't think that I would ever, ever try to judge you. I just want to lift you because I know what it's like. I know you're tired. I know your super outfit's hanging up and you look at it every day and go, do I really want to put this on? But I want to read something to you that I think is so powerful. They did a study in the U.S. They took data to do a study of what they felt that if a mom was paid what she was worth, what her salary would be. They broke it down, and by the end of the year, it came to $506,000 a year. I don't know, I think that's low. This survey was taken several years ago. Just kidding. But listen to what they broke it down to. Animal caretaker, $17,000. Executive chef, $40,000. Computer system analyst, $44,000. Financial manager, $39,000. Food and beverage worker, $20,000. General office clerk, $19,000. Registered nurse, $35,000. Management analyst, $41,000. Child care worker, $13,000. Housekeeper, $9,000. Psychologist, $29,000. Bus driver, $32,000. Elementary school principal, $58,000. Dietitian and nutritionist, $41,000. Property manager, $22,000. Social worker, $30,000. Recreation worker, $15,000. It's a lot. But there are a lot of things that money can't buy. And there's no way that you and I could have put a price on them. Kissing a boo-boo, priceless. Fixing their favorite meal that they love, priceless. Making them feel special on their birthday, priceless. Getting up during the middle of the night, priceless. Refereeing their disputes, priceless. Searching the entire house for the lost gerbil, priceless. Cheering from the sidelines, priceless. That's me. I got video of me and all you can hear is me screaming. They're like, Mom, oh my gosh, you screamed the whole time. Yeah, I did. Because it is priceless. Scratching their back while they go to sleep and praying for them, priceless. Baking cookies for them when they come home from school, priceless. Telling stories at bedtime, priceless. Giving them dreams, priceless. Holding their hands during their shots, priceless. Giving a hug, a smile, and a word of encouragement, priceless. Being a mom, priceless. You and I get to hold these precious gifts. And even if you're not a mom, you may have nieces and nephews. You may have friends that have kids. We get to hold these kids. We get to guide them. We get to teach them. We get to carry the mommy moment and never forget. But I know right now you're saying, this is all great. Thank you, Way. Woohoo! Thank you, Mama G. But I'm done. I'm tired. I know. I want to pray for you. I want you to know you're not alone ever. You have a God that loves you, that said he would equip you, that said he would give you everything you needed. And you have friends. G5, you have us. Moms, we have each other. If you need to dump, this is what I tell everybody. Just text me and say, get out the bucket. And you can, I'll get the bucket out. You can let it all out so you don't let it out on your kids and your husband. And then we can go back to what God called us to do. I love you. I love your superhero outfit. You look the bomb in it, no matter what you think. You can do this. And maybe you're saying, this is awesome, and you're talking about this God that, and this Jesus that can give me the strength and can give me the words, but I don't even know about this. I know. I want to help you. If you will simply just ask him, Jesus, come into my heart. Jesus, I pray for wisdom. Jesus, I pray that you'll forgive me and that you'll guide me. See, one of the things, moms, I pray every morning when I get up is, God, give me wisdom as a mom and as a wife and as a woman. Help me be aware. Mom, sometimes we're just not aware. Help us be aware. And I call out my husband in prayer, and I call out our children in prayer, and I call out you in prayer. I want to pray for you right now. And I pray that you right now would just pull out your hand, even if you're a dad, even if you're a child, and I want you to lift your hand out. Father, I thank you for this moment. I thank you for God moments. I thank you for mom moments. I thank you for miracle moments. And I know, God, that at the sound of my voice, that you are speaking to people right now. There are moms that are so tired. Right now, I speak strength. I pray, God, that you would just strengthen them up. That, God, a peace would come over there and that there's no understanding. That there would be a peace that they could not explain. And that, God, that they would start seeing the gifts that you've given them in a different way. Help them to view these moments as so special. Father, help us to love ourselves so that we can love our children. I thank you for what you're doing. You're so powerful. The enemy has no place. I speak to you. You are bound in the name of Jesus. You have no place, and you will no longer defeat these moms. You will no longer keep them under. You will let them shine and let their gifts come forward. And you, Father, will gird them up and make them mighty. I thank you, God, for what you're doing, and we're going to give you the glory and the praise. In your precious name we pray. Amen. I love you. Go be a mom. Be encouraged. Be equipped. You're amazing. Happy Mother's Day.
Can I just challenge dads? Can I just challenge you? Grab your kids today and make this the most incredible Mother's Day you've ever had. Find some flowers. You might even have to pick some wild ones. If your neighbor's got beautiful ones in their yard, you might have to run over and get one. I can't believe I said that.
Those are the best.
That. But I'm serious. Serve her. Open her door.
Amen.
Pull out her chair. Give her a place of honor. I want to challenge you to read Proverbs 31. And I want to thank you for being that lady. I want to thank you for being that mom. I want to thank you for the moments and the memories that you're pouring into our children. Let's make this the greatest day for moms. The Bible says that when they go into heaven, that their works will go before them. And they'll welcome them. Go read it. Moms, be encouraged. I know this sounds like a lot. I know you're already doing a lot, but you're so powerful.
Amen.
I also want to say it's so great today because we've got our brand new cameras for Mama's Day, man.
Woo-hoo!
And we're having a blast. I hope they make me look better. But you might want to sow a special gift today in honor of your mom to just say, let me keep reaching more people around the world.
Amen.
You're amazing. May God's peace, power, and favor, and promotion be on you.
Great job, baby.
Thank
you. You killed it.
Happy Mother's Day. We love you.
Bye-bye.
It's Mother's Day. Your favorite children are here to wish you Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day, Mom.
So there's no Happy Mother's Day, so I'm sure there is, but... Happy Mother's Day to you.
You can make it.
Happy Mother's Day to you.
Good boy. Okay, go. Happy Mother's Day.
It's early in the morning. My voice ain't prepared for
Happy
yet.
Happy
so.
Mother's Day to you.
Really? Come on. Where else gonna go? Thank you.
You're the lead to you.
Remember, I can only sing to
you
what
have
I hear.
Beautiful eyes, by the way.
What I tell myself
it's
every
gorgeous.
Day.
Gorgeous. But, Mom, we just wanted to say Happy Mother's Day. You know, I think Blake and I are incredibly amazed that God chose you to be our mom. And we will never, ever be able to explain the blessing that has been. Mm-hmm. You have been so real through our entire sphere of life. She just always leads with strength. She always leads with honesty. She always leads with realness. You're so open about, hey, I messed up here, but I'm working on it and I'm growing. And you've led with such just obedience to follow Jesus. And I think one thing I truly love about you is you've shown Blake and I the love you have for our Father and the honor that you have for our Father. And the way you support him and everything he does. I know for us, you've given us such an incredible visual and in what a godly relationship looks like. And so for us going in, growing up, and one day getting into relationships ourselves, I know that we have this incredible example of what a woman can be if she honors God and lives for his word and follows what he asks. And so Blake and I just wanted to say how much we love you, how grateful we are for you. We know that our house and our life would instantly probably fall apart if it wasn't for Mom. You do things that are, I'm sure, taken for granted, but you lead and you do things without even asking for appreciation or noticing, but we want you to know that we notice everything you do.
Nah, you know she demands it.
No.
I'm just kidding.
You're absolutely incredible, Mom. We love you. Thank you for your heart. I will say this. I think you are the most selfless person I know. You give unconditionally, always. If Blake and I want something from your plate, food-wise, you're like, give
it,
take
it. Oh, no, that's you.
It.
I can't eat any of it.
You
I'm allergic.
You used to.
What would I ever eat off of Mom's plate?
Come on. No,
I'm joking, people.
All I'm saying, Mom, is that you give continuously, 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 and you love us endlessly, endlessly, endlessly. And we are forever grateful for who you are and who you've become and what you've overcame. And so we hope this is an incredible Mother's Day. Mm-hmm. You're going to be spending it with us.
I was going to say, so it's going to be amazing.
It's going to be so much fun. We can't wait to celebrate you. And,
all I gotta say is if you need me to spell anything she just said, ain't gonna happen. Sorry.
You can spell Mother's Day. We'll talk about it later. But we love you, Mom. We're really excited, actually, that Moms, we have a special gift for you as well.
Yes, we do.
From your kids, from your family. So stay tuned. We got a special song and a special moment for you guys. So.
Happy Mother's Day, Moms. And happy Mother's Day, Mom. And, watch the next part of this video. It's really cool.
Love
y'all.
You might have a mom, she might be the bomb, but ain't nobody got a mom like mine. Her love's to the end, she's my best friend. Ain't nobody got a mom like mine. She's my world, she's my heart, and there's no denying I'm her girl. Taught me how to love myself. You might
just wanted to say happy Mother's Day from G5. We love you. This is for you. We hope you have an incredible day. Happy Mother's Day.
You might have a mom, she might be the bomb, but ain't nobody got a mom like mine.